Now, Strega Nona is one of my best loved series of books, and that came about because I was asked to retell a folktale, and the first folktale I thought of was the Porridge Pot. But I reread it, and I thought, oh, yeah, this wasn't back in the 70s. Modern kids don't know what porridge is. Nobody, I mean, people are eating more oatmeal now than they were then. But there was, so I did a lot of research on those kind of tales, and there's Why the Sea is Salt, the rice bowl, the porridge pot. So it made it to make it more accessible to me and to modern children. I changed the porridge to pasta, and created Big Anthony. But that's what I love about rediscovering folk tales and then retelling them. To kind of either update them or make them funnier or put my own spin on it. And I remember when I first met Diane, I'm going to get her name wrong, I think it's Folkstein. Oh, well, anyway, she's a big, important storyteller in New York City. And she wasn't publishing any books because she never liked to tell a story the same way twice. Whereas I think that, once you get a good idea, then you build on that. But the storytellers were the children's book or were the community storytellers or shamans of the community. That's how information got passed down to the group. And that's, I think, what we do. We're just doing it with a modern twist when we publish books for children. Because that's what story hour is in libraries.